Well, hello there. It's me, suited in black, and you're probably wondering what in the world is going on with this video. Like, why am I wearing white? Where even are we? I've completely changed a location. I've changed country. But anyway, basically, I'm in Italy and I'm doing a video for my computer. So sorry if the video quality for this video sucks. So it'll be this way for a couple of videos whilst I catch up because my recording and video schedule have been absolute shit. But hopefully we can get back on track and start making more reviews. So look forward to more stuff. So what shall we discuss today? How about another book review? Does that sound good? Let's get to it. So I recently finished a book and I quite enjoyed it, but I also felt like there were quite a few aspects that I felt didn't quite work and they didn't really add up to a whole. They felt like they were kind of clashing a little bit with each other, so it was a bit slightly mixed, a bit of a mixed bag, this book, that some elements I liked, while some elements I thought were just a bit just kind of not really well developed. And therefore, I thought this book, in to get things out of the way, I felt this book was a bit unbalanced. So let's see here. Oh, and this book is by J.K. Rowling, so that's going to be controversial. And if you thought this was Harry Potter, well, you're wrong. Actually, this book is her first attempt at writing adult fiction, and that is, of course, the casual Vacancy. So before we get into all the good stuff and the bad stuff and my overall rating and also how I think this book could be improved, I'll just sort of have a quick enough summary of my thoughts before we go into depth. So I thought this book was fine. It kind of delivered its premise and it kind of had a solid drama story, let's say. But as I've said before, I think this book's a little bit, just a little bit unbalanced. So some aspects you'll find better represented, better developed than other aspects. So let's get things out of the way first. So the casual Vacancy is about this parish councillor who dies suddenly of a heart attack, and this town has to sort of understand, or they have to elect a new councillor for their town. And so there's a lot of political themes, a lot of very mature themes about I suppose deceptiveness, but also about just ordinary life. But there's also, quite surprisingly, a lot of teenage kind of stuff going on. A lot of this book is dedicated to like teen sex and drugs, and it's quite interesting and also a bit odd, and so to speak, if you understand what I mean, that's a bit doesn't quite fit with adult fiction. But so what's the first thing that's good about this book? So I've written characterization. So I thought the characters were well created and they were well portrayed, and they had a lot of humanity to them that you could really sort of empathize with what they were going through. You sort of understand their feelings of anger and fear and sadness, and all this kind of mundane stuff is just really actually quite well done, to be perfectly honest. I actually did sort of believe what was happening with every single adult and teenage character. So I thought the characterizations were pretty solid. Like the characterization of Crystal is really well done, actually. She's really sympathetic. She at first she kind of seems like you're slightly misbehaving type of student who just kind of goes around fucking and doing drugs, but she actually turns out to be really caring and really sort of she's going through crap to help her brother and hopefully her mum. So she was someone who was actually had a really interesting and really engaging motivation and a drive for her role in the story. And also another character who's also a teenager who actually I didn't mind, it was actually Andrew or Arf. I hate that name, actually. I hate Arf. I hate that nickname. But Andrew, I thought, was also interesting, a little bit dislikable at first because he uses such profanity in such a disgusting way, but then you actually see him trying to stop his dad always being an asshole to him, and he actually tries to find a job and have something to do. And he actually starts to dislike his friend, who he starts to realize is quite an asshole in the end. He's really sort of all about this friend character called Fats is really just nasty. He's a nasty bully. He bullies this poor girl who cuts herself, and then he's just a really, really well, what's the word? He just doesn't behave well, let's say. That's such a plain way of putting it. I also found the episodic structure of this book to actually be really quite good. It actually shows it's almost like a soap opera in some way that it when one thing begins, another thing continues or also begins or goes to an end. And it kind of really does this kind of here's one bit of the story, here's another bit, and here's another bit, and they're all kind of like building blocks. So it's actually really really quite well done. It really keeps you going. It really makes you curious to where the story actually is going. So that's another really good thing that I liked about this book. Okay, let me try to explain what I mean by an episodic structure. So take your average book. Usually it's a chapter by chapter by chapter, and there are, let's say, 10 chapters each. And they're more of an ongoing sort of plot. Whilst the casual vacancy is like mostly just made up of parts and just breaks in the text. And I feel like that this kind of very here's part one of part one or text, I don't know how to put it. Here's this part of part one and then here's the next part, and they're quite short, and I feel like they're you can easily read them. They're very quite fast in some way. They're you can easily read them quite quickly, and yeah. So hopefully that explains what I mean by episodic structure. So this book really is ambitious. It's really trying to have all these different themes and all these different characters just play a big part in this overall arching story about, not just about someone trying to become a parish councillor and also about the death of this recent parish councillor, but also about things like teen sex, teen drugs, all that, family drama is really makes the story really a bit more interesting, a bit more like it's really wanting to build on these themes in such a way that there makes them in a way that makes them engaging, that they're be trying to make them even more important than how you would typically view these themes of like family drama. And yeah, so I think this book is very ambitious, and I do like that. I do respect that, but that's also leans on why I feel like this book is a little bit unbalanced. So that's going to, we'll talk about that soon. And I thought the ending was also quite a strong bit. It really just ends on a really poignant note. So spoilers for those who haven't read the book, but basically this main character dies and their little brother dies as well. And I thought that it's leading up to these deaths was actually really quite sad. It was really engaging and quite a little bit stressful that these characters are so hopeless and they're so unsure what to do that they just end up dying. And so when the main character cannot save their younger sibling, they just so spoiler, major spoilers right now, but they drug themselves to death, and I thought that was a really sort of a good way to end the whole sort of drug theme that they use it to kill themselves, and I thought that was really really sad, really poignant, and it really sort of speaks about how much I suppose teenagers just abuse drugs, and that it's almost like a lifestyle, and it's something that they can just use to get away from life or get away from responsibilities. But well, and about responsibilities, that's actually quite the turn of things, because this character died because she wants to they want to be with their younger sibling, so it's that kind of responsibility of their of who they are as an older significant other that made it really fascinating for me. Well, that sounds like a lot of good things for this book. But unfortunately, I have to talk about the stuff that I did not like about this book. So let's get into it. So let's start with the smallest complaint. And I thought that the book's humor was very weird. Like, I did not understand what exactly was funny about it. I didn't understand exactly what I was supposed to laugh at, what the kind of the misery was in a way. And there's this one moment where it talks about this guy's dick, and it's like he's so fat you can't see his dick, and they wonder what he does with it. And I thought that was so awkward, and it was actually not a good joke. I actually thought that's actually a bit offensive. It's not funny at all. So that's the kind of humor that sometimes you stumble across in this book, and it just makes me either pop my eyes like that. Like, what am I reading? Or it just makes you wonder what exactly were they thinking? What is their perception of comedy in this book? Like, is it supposed to look at misery, or is it actually bullying in one in some way out someone's out outside? But basically, this humor is just really awkward, and that's just all I can see is that, is just that I didn't like the humor that much. So there is some cute moments where during two funerals they play the song Umbrella by Rihanna, and it's like, okay, that's cute. But then also got a little bit annoying, and it's also that's what the book also ends on. It ends on the Rihanna song for this particular character's funeral, which is quite cute. It kind of pays homage to them, but it also is a little bit reminds me that the humor is a bit not really that good. Next complaint. You'll probably remember this complaint from my other book review, but let's look at redundant prose. So basically, not all of this book's prose is redundant. In fact, this book is actually kind of eloquent. It does have quite nice ways of describing things, of showing the mood, showing the setting, showing the sort of the history and the culture of this town, and that is quite nice. There's also some moments that I feel like add a bit too much. Like, they say that someone's patience, I think, I don't know what it was, but they used the covering a table with a sheet metaphor, and it's completely smooth as a metaphor for something. And I thought that was like a bit of a weird kind of moment of prose. That's the kind of metaphor that goes a bit too far, in my opinion. It's a bit trying too hard. That's also why this book's ambition kind of falls on its face, because it's trying a bit too hard to be eloquent, to look at many themes, and therefore you can even tell in the prose that J.K. Rowling was trying a little bit too hard. And the thing about this, let me just check, the prose is that adult prose doesn't necessarily need to be supremely eloquent. You can just write prose that does have good metaphors, that good metaphors, and like that they're not too trying too much. They're quite easy to understand and grasp. And like, there's all sorts of different debates you could do for this, but in my opinion, you could do a prose that's much more not looking down on others, but just kind of easy to grasp and warm and down to earth. That's how I'd like to read an adult piece, but this one's quite as I've said, it's a little bit up its arse about its style. So yeah, that's one thing I didn't like about. Oh, sorry, stupid motorcycles. And I'll explain that in a little bit. So yeah. All right. Now it's time for my biggest complaint of this book, and I've talked about it already. I've already mentioned it before, but that's the fact that this book is very imbalanced. It's really trying too hard to balance all these different characters, all these different themes, all these different plot lines, and the fact that it doesn't follow an overarching plot. It's like, this is the main plot, and then we have all these other different plots underneath. And it does add a lot of complexity and sophistication to the story and the setting, but it also feels like it's not really doing so much justice to each aspect of the story. So I felt that was very disappointing. I really wanted to explore each character, each themes, each story, and in a much more compelling way. Like, I'm not sure how to make it more compelling, but if it were more fun to read or something, then I would have sort of given it a better praise. And there's some things also about the characters that feel very imbalanced. So, for example, you have some good characters like Crystal. You have some characters you can kind of sympathize with, but you don't really like, such as Terry, that's Crystal's mum. And then you have characters like Andrew, who you kind of root for later on rather than the beginning. And then there are characters who I have absolutely no idea if this was the intention, but you hate the guts out of these characters. And the biggest one is Simon, which is Andrew's father. And I have no idea if I was supposed to empathize with him, because I spent the entire book hating his guts. He was saying stuff like, plug it up, like in Carrie, like, what the fuck? It's such a... That's what bullies say when someone's got a serious condition. You don't just say, plug it up. Plug it up, plug it up, plug it up. No, you have to think about it seriously. You can't just be an asshole about it. So I'm not sure if that was intentional, but I hated it. And to make things even worse, Simon is domestically violent. He abuses his wife and his kids. So it's like, this guy's evil. He's a monster. So get him out of the book. Get him out of the story. Why? What's going on with this character? Why? And then there's some characters who I didn't quite care about. And then there were some characters who I thought were just like dumb. I thought Gavin was a bit stupid, in my opinion. And I thought Mary was a little bit boo-hoo. She cries throughout the whole book. She doesn't have any change. That sounds so mean, but it's true. I wanted to see changes in the characters, except for Simon. Simon is irredeemable. I hate him. So, yeah, that's just my rant on the book being a bit imbalanced. So, yeah, that's my biggest gripe of the casual Vacancy. But other than that, I think this book is all right. So in the end, what kind of reception does this book get? So just before I give the rating, I'm just going to explain that this book is really ambitious, and I do recommend it in some way. I do suggest that you should read this book if you're curious, or if you want a book that tackles many themes and many storylines at once, then I'd say go ahead and read it. I recommend it. But I've already said that this book has quite a few things that I didn't like about it, and unfortunately they're too big enough to make me say this book gets a suited good. I think this book is knocked down a little bit. To a point, I like it. I do like The Casual Vacancy, but it doesn't go above because of those flaws. So I'm sorry to say that. So in the end, this book gets a suited average. So I do recommend it, but as I said, it's a bit average, so read it if you want to. So, thank you so much for watching my book review on the casual vacancy, and please excuse the fact that I have a white shirt. Well, it's actually the white shirt of my suited and black uniform, but I don't have the black shirt. And also excuse the fact that I'm using the camera of the computer, and also that I'm in a completely different room, and also that my hair is extremely short, so. And you can't really see my beard, can you? So anyway, thank you very much for watching. So until we meet again, I'll be waiting.
I see it.